I think it's about time we build some new shortcuts. I've got Shortcuts that downloads all the images or PDFs from a web page at once. A better way to save YouTube videos to Apple Notes. Keep a log of all the restaurants you visited so you can go back and reference it. Use ChatGPT to create calendar events from your email. And I have new action button shortcuts for my phone and my watch. And many of these requests are for those in my Shortcuts community, where you can join over 1,300 people, chat with other Shortcuts enthusiasts, or share your own. And if you become a member of the community for $5 a month, you can join almost 300 people where you get priority Shortcuts requests, access to my custom-trained Shortcuts GPT, and I'm using my Shortcuts GPT more and more to build the advanced shortcuts you see in these videos. And I've started a new thing called Shortcut of the Week, where I'll share a new shortcut every Monday that you won't see in these videos. So if you'd like to join that community, go to create.beard.fm. I'm in there interacting with everyone, and I'm thinking about even more benefits coming very soon. First up, I wanted a shortcut that would download all the images or PDFs from a web page. So what this shortcut does, and I built this with the Shortcuts GPT, it asks if you want to download PDFs or images. Then it uses match text commands to find all the URLs on a web page that might be images or PDFs, and then saves them to the downloads folder on your device. This should work on your iPhone, iPad, or your Mac. So when you're on a web page like beard.fm, you can tap the share button, go to download images or PDFs. The menu is going to ask you which one you'd like to download. Let's choose images. You'll have to tap always allow whenever you do this on a new website for the first time. And after a few seconds, all those images are going to be in your downloads folder. So if we go over to the files app, there's the image that was on the web page and it's saved on my device. And this works great with PDFs. Here I am on the IRS's website and maybe there's a bunch of forms that I just want to download quickly. I'll go to my download images or PDFs, tap PDFs here, and then it'll find any PDF on the page, save it to my downloads folder. And you can see those PDFs are downloaded and saved to my files. There's that W9 form and any other PDFs that were on the page. Now let's say you have some images on your iPhone and you want to make them into PDFs. Well, this shortcut I made right here called Photos to PDF and Rename. You can use this from the share sheet, and every image that goes through, it's going to repeat this process, make a PDF from that image, gives you a chance to rename it, and then it's going to ask you where to save it. You can toggle that off if you'd like to choose a specific folder for all of these to save to. But here I am on my images. I'll tap the share button. I'll go to Photos to PDF and Name. I'll name the file, and that should now be in the folder that I chose. And there's that photo, now a PDF saved in my downloads folder. Next, this was a request from the community, and they wanted to be alerted when their battery was under 20%, but not when they were in their sleep focus mode. So this shortcut, we're actually going to create an automation with it, but it gets the focus, and if you're in the sleep focus, it won't do anything, so no notification. But if you're not in sleep focus or otherwise, you'll get a notification when your battery is below 20%. Then what we would do to create an automation, go to the middle tab here, tap the plus icon, and then we'll go down to where you have the battery level option. We want to go falls below, and you could put this at 20, just like that. We want it to run immediately, tap next, and then let's search for battery alert if not asleep. And we just tap that shortcut and it will run when your battery percentage falls below 20. Number four, another request, someone wanted to get the latest or newest file in a folder on their device and save it to a bare note. So what this does is it's gonna ask you what folder to look at. It's gonna get the latest or newest item from that folder and create a bare note with that file attached. So when you run the shortcut, it'll ask you to choose a folder. Let's go with the downloads folder. Since I've been working with that one, we'll tap open. Hit done. Then it's going to open bare, create that note with the file attached. Now the naming scheme will take the file name, and that's a little messy, but if you wanted to, you could tap here and you can choose ask each time. And that's actually how I'll share this shortcut down in the video description, which you can get links to all these shortcuts down there. So it will ask what you want to title the note and then save the file. Next, this was from Steve in the community. He wanted to be able to save YouTube videos, but have the publish date, the thumbnail, and of course the link all in one place, also who the video was by. And this time we're gonna do it with Bear Notes. Now again, you can do this with Apple Notes by trading out these last steps for it. I had a video on that previously. I'll find it and link it above here. But we can run this when we're looking at a YouTube video, or it can also work if we just get our clipboard. Let's go to a YouTube video like this one. We'll hit the share button here. And remember, with YouTube's menu, you have to swipe all the way over and go to more, and then you can run your shortcuts down here. We're gonna run our YouTube video to bare shortcut. It's gonna get all the information, and just that quickly, it created the note. Let's go over to bare, and now it adds that to the YouTube saved document with the thumbnail of the video, the title, who it's by, and a link to watch it. Number 6. Pete from the community wanted a shortcut to keep track of restaurants he's eaten at and as we can go back if he liked them. So what this shortcut will do is get restaurants near your current location, you choose the one you just ate at, it gets the address to that restaurant, and then populates all that information in text and appends it to a note. Now you can have it ask each time, or of course you can manually choose the same note. Let's actually clear the variable for a second, tap where it says note, and now we can choose from our entire notes list. Let's create a note called favorite restaurants and we'll put it there. So let's run this shortcut. Let's pick a restaurant from the list that's nearby, tap always allow on that location. And if we go back to our Apple note, it saved that information, the restaurant name, restaurant address, and the date where we ate there. It takes today's date. Now, if you wanted to add like a review, let's call this rating. So I've added a little menu here at the top with a star rating. And when we run it, it'll now ask us what we rated the restaurant. We'll say 5 stars. Where did we eat? Maybe the Dummy Krabby. And now it's going to add that or append it to the note we already had. There's the restaurant, and it now has the rating. Let me add one more little element here, which is just a little line break so it'll separate the restaurants in the future. And this is the version of the shortcut I'll share in the video description. You can do a rating, choose the restaurant, and now it's going to add it to the note with that line separator so it's nicely organized. Another request from the community was when you get an email with information about an event or something you want to add to your calendar, how can you do that with a shortcut? So this requires the ChatGPT app, so you'll need to have that downloaded on your phone and opened recently. It gets a little buggy. I have a prompt here that looks for a date somewhere in the email, tries to ignore older dates and events that were mentioned if it was a long email chain or quoted. It gets the dates, and then we'll create a calendar event from that. Now this is specifically made to accept PDFs or the clipboard. So you can copy the text of the email and then run the shortcut, or run it as a PDF, and I'll show you how to do that now. So when you're looking at an email with a possible date, there might be a suggestion from the stock calendar app, but that doesn't happen all the time. So to run this shortcut, we're actually going to tap the reply button, but then we're going to go to the print command. If you didn't know, you can go to print an email and then make a PDF just by pinching out, and now you have a PDF of that email. Or you could tap the share button up here, which is what we're going to do to run this shortcut. We're going to find our event from email GPT. It's going to send that to ChatGPT. It's going to try to ascertain an event from the context of the email. And now we have the compose sheet for that event with the title, basically from the email, and the date and time that was suggested. And I did this with a PDF because if it's a really long email, it might not be on screen when you need it. And the PDF will make sure to get all the content in the message. This next one is a priority request from Sander in the Netherlands. They wanted an automation to run regularly that looks at their calendar events. And if it is an event that requires driving or traveling to, then it's going to add 60 minutes before and after that event as padding in his calendar. So what this shortcut does is checks all your calendar events. If the location of the event is either a Microsoft Teams link, because it's a virtual meeting, or the location does not have any value, meaning there's no address you have to travel to, it's going to ignore those events. Otherwise, it's actually going to adjust the start and end time for that event with an hour added before and after, giving enough buffer for travel time. It also does something here, which it adds in the notes section of the event, the word adjusted. This way you can automate the shortcut to run once a week, and it will ignore any events that have the word adjusted in the notes. So you can be sure it's not going to add an additional hour or 2 hours to the beginning and end of events. If this is something that's useful to you, I'd love to hear about it. Or if you want a variation, let me know in the comments below. I see those requests too. Next, a request from the community was just, I want to save URLs in Safari to a note. This is going to create a new note with the title of the web page as the title of the note, and just the plain URL is going to be in the body. So let's go to Safari and run this. So if we were on a web page, we can hit the share button. We'll go to save link to notes. And it simply creates an Apple note. The title of the article or web page is the title of the note, and the URL is right there. Now, I've mentioned I've switched up the action button both from my phone and my watch. And I'll be honest, I went a little advanced. First, let's start with the phone. I've changed my action button because I'm starting to use the Perplexity voice assistant more now that it has access to your phone. But I don't want it all the time, and I still want my action button to skip forward 3 minutes when audio is playing. That's how I skip the ads and all the podcasts I listen to. So this shortcut uses Toolbox Pro actions. I'll link to that in the description. If audio is playing, that's the first thing it checks for, it will skip forward by 3 minutes. So it can skip those ads when I'm listening to a podcast. If there is no audio playing, Then it's going to start a voice mode chat with Perplexity. So I can just hold the action button, and most of the time, it just starts a voice chat. But I also wanted this shortcut to have my action button be a garage door opener. But I wanted to be very careful when it actually works that way. So the second part of the shortcut gets my current location. It also gets details about the current audio output device. That is a Toolbox Pro action as well. Then I have an if statement that if all are true. So both my phone's audio output needs to be my car. So that means I'm driving, I'm connected to Bluetooth, and my current location, I am on my street. Now this is not my street. I usually put mine there, but you'll need to put your car name there, at least what it shows up in your Bluetooth settings, and then your home street address. I typically leave off the number and just do the name of the street, and then that's going to toggle my garage door. But that's only going to run if I'm connected to my car and at home. This is how I've been rocking with my action button on my phone, but for my Apple Watch, I'm doing something a little different. This is my Apple Watch Master Action Button, and this was inspired by members of the community, but also some of my recent habits. First, I wanted the action button on my Apple Watch to be a flashlight when I'm in my sleep focus. So it gets my focus mode. If I'm in the sleep focus, it just turns the flashlight for my watch on. Helps me if I'm getting up in the middle of the night. Then, if I'm filming like I am right now, I can tap the action button and it's going to run my done recording HomeKit scene so I can quickly get back to office work, turn off the studio lights and all of that. Otherwise, it's going to start a traditional strength training workout with an open goal on my watch. That's something I've been doing in the mornings with my son, and I like to be able to quickly go to that workout automatically. And those are really the only times I use my Apple Watch action button. I've been thinking about adding other focus modes and changing it, but what's convenient is I can go to my sleep focus, and now that I'm in sleep, I can hit the action button on my Apple Watch, checks for that focus mode, and you'll see it's now a flashlight. And now that I'm back in my filming focus mode, if I hit it, it would change my HomeKit scene. All right, two more quick ones. Another request from the community. They wanted a shortcut that asks for a time and then sets a bunch of alarms for the next day so they can take medications. So what this shortcut does is it asks for a time, then it will create multiple alarms throughout the day, 6 hours ahead of the first time that you select for afternoon alarm, and then another 6 hours for the nighttime alarm. And it also creates reminders for the same time. They wanted both. So when you run this shortcut, it asks for a time. And that quickly just ran through all those alarms. Let's check the clock app to see if those alarms were created. And then we have morning, afternoon, and evening med alarms. Now, instead of having them all created at the same time, if you wanted those alarms to be created when you turn off the last one, you can do this in the automations tab. When you tap the plus icon here, you can choose alarm as the trigger, and then when an alarm is stopped. You can also choose an existing alarm, so you could say when my morning meds alarm is stopped, and then we want this to run immediately. Then we can create a new blank automation. We're going to start with an adjust date command, and we're going to change seconds to hours, and then add 6 hours to the current date. That also includes the time. And then we can search for the alarm action. And we're going to create an alarm and tap the adjusted date. So that's when it will set it for. And let's call this afternoon meds. So when you stop the morning meds alarm, it will create the afternoon meds alarm. And then to get the most fancy, let's search for alarm here in actions. And we're going to tap the delete alarms action. We can have it ask each time, or we can type it in. If I add a text block with the label of the alarm exactly, then I can choose to delete the text and it will delete the morning meds alarm when this runs. Then you can create another one for the evening meds, and then these will only be created when you stop the previous alarm. All right, and finally, this last request from the community, they wanted some templates for creating new notes in Bear, but having it all kind of built in. So what this does is you can choose from a menu. These are various templates for different notes, and then I have some pre-filled text, and because Bear is a great supporter of Markdown, all these are going to look great. And then you can title the note when you run the shortcut. So if I run this and let's say, what's the new project? We can call this primary technology, which by the way, that's my tech podcast. You should definitely subscribe, link above and in the description. We'll tap done. And then it creates a bare note with that template. And it's also tagged by the template name. And that's programmed here in the shortcuts actions. You can go to the create bare note action, expand it, and change the tag here. So those are 13 new shortcuts, many of them coming from you in the community. And remember, you can join at create.beard.fm. That link is in the description. Plus $5 a month, you get the Shortcuts GPT, the shortcut of the week, which I'm going to show you what that's going to be. I used to have some great wallpaper shortcuts that used Unsplash's API, and they shut down access to that. So I did a little workaround, and this shortcut, when you run it, will get a random wallpaper from the Unsplash wallpapers topic. It'll show you a preview of the image and then ask you in the menu if you want to save that image to your camera roll or try again. And when you try again, it'll give you another option. Yeah, I like that one better. I think I'm going to save it. And that shortcut is only going to be available in my shortcut of the week when you support the community with $5 a month. And becoming a member there is supporting the channel as a whole. And I'm solo here. I don't have a team. It's just me creating these videos. And so thank you so much for all of those who support the channel here, directly on YouTube and in my podcast, which again, I have a weekly tech podcast I would love for you to check out. I'll actually link it right up here. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, be sure to get subscribed, hit that like button, leave your shortcuts request in the comments below this video and in the community. And if you want to fall down the rabbit hole of all the shortcuts I've done, every video is in this playlist and you'll be occupied for several hours. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.